Hello, dear students, welcome to our today's online class. You know, the departments of English has begun their online classes for the students of honors and masters, and for those BA pass and others. So this is our today's online class for the students of honors first year, and I am with you Munmun Ahmed, assistant professor, department of English, government BM college, Borishal. And you know, you are passing your 100 and more days at your home, leaving your campus and outer life. And undoubtedly, it is an unusual experience. But this experience teaches us how to fight with an enemy that is unseen. And you know, who is that unseen enemy? The answer is COVID-19. And this is known as coronavirus. So, this experience teaches us how to survive, how to fight. And it is your responsibility to be conscious, to make yourself and your family members, that means the people around you. So be conscious and to make others being conscious. And it is also your responsibility to continue your studies and to continue all the activities which can make your life normal. Okay? So, sorry. Our today's class from the course of English writing skill. In writing skill, we have letter. Letter is a topic from which you have to answer brief and short questions. At the same time, in your guided writing, you have to write formal and informal letters. So try to give importance on the topic later. And please, I request everyone to have your pen and paper before you when you are going to watch our online classes. So, what are the topics today we are going to discuss? First, we know what are the topics. The topics for the first one is what is a letter. Then, what are the types of letter? Then, number three, what is formal letter and what is informal letter? Number four, what are the parts or elements of letter? Then, at last, we discuss what is the difference between formal and informal letter. So, first of all, you should put down the topics what we are going to discuss. and I think you can see the board. So these are these five topics you should put down in your paper. Okay? So later, what is later? You are very much well known with the term later, because you had to write later from class 6 to 10 in your exam. So you are already, you have already well known with the topics. But what is a later? If we define a later, then what we can say? A letter is written or printed message. Written or printed message. Or written or printed conversation between two parties. Who are the parties? Number one, the writer of the letter. Who writes the letter? And number two, the recipient to whom he writes. Okay? So what is a letter? A letter is a written or printed message or conversation between two parties. It serves, you know, as it is a written document, then a letter serves as a permanent record and it is a valuable repository of information. It is a valuable repository of information which one can refer to future. That means you can preserve it and it can serve as a record for future times. Till today, a letter is an important form of communication both in the workplace or our private lives. Although email, texts, and other such forms have become the norm of communication, email, you are well known with the term email, text. That means the short message we write. And other such forms have become the norm of communication. A lot of our communication, especially the formal kind, is done via letters. So, still now, letter has a great demand both in our personal lives or in our academic or official lives. So, this is letter. Now, you can write about what is a letter. Sorry. Then, types of letter. What are the types of letter? Letters are of two types. Letters are of two types. Formal and informal letter. Formal letter and informal letter. What is formal letter? A formal letter follow a certain pattern and formality. It follows a prescribed format. Okay? And formal letters are strictly kept professional in nature and directly address the issues concerned. Any type any type of business letters, any type of business letters or letter to any authorities falls within this category. Within this category, that means any types of business letters or letter to authorities are considered as formal letter. Some personal or social letters. Some personal or social letters, that is acceptance letters, invitation cards, these are also known as formal letter. You know, invitation cards, what we have to make to invite our people, and acceptance letter. It is what is an acceptance letter? It is a letter, it is a positive response to either an invitation or a job offer. Okay, so this is formal letters. Now, what are informal letters? Informal letters are actually personal letters, which is used for casual and personal communication. Through formal letters, one tries to express one's thoughts and feelings to others. Its tone is subjective, you know, as it reflects the writer's personal thoughts, feelings, ideas or experiences. So the tone is subjective. Generally, the informal letters are written to family members, your friends, your acquaintances and relatives, etc. An informal letter doesn't necessarily need a format, but it has a standard. Okay, the language of an informal letter is simple and lucid. This is all about formal and informal letters. Now let us come to the fourth point. That means, what are the parts of a letter? The parts of both formal and informal letters has 6 parts. Both formal and informal letters has 6 parts. Number 1, number 1, heading. What is heading? Address of the writer and date on the left and address of the recipient on the right. This is heading. Address of the writer and date on the left and address of the recipient on the right. This is heading. Number 2, salutation. Salutation is one kind of greetings. That means addressing the people the writer is going to write the letter. This is salutation. What we write in salutation? That means informal letter. We write Mr. X, Y, Z or Dear Sir and so on. And in informal letter, we write, we usually write my dear sister, my elder brother, dear father, dear mother, dear XYZ and so on. This is salutation. Number three, body of the letter. Body of the letter. Body of the letter, it conveys the message of the letter. That means informal letter, it conveys the message, and especially to academics and others, there is another part you have to write subject. But informal letter, this is just the body of the letter. That means the message the writer wants to write. Number four, subscription. Number four, subscription. Subscription, what is subscription? It's a short piece of writing at the end of the document. It is also known as complimentary clause. Complimentary clause. In formal letter, you write like sincerely yours, yours truly, yours faithfully, and so on. And in informal letters, you have to write your lovingly, your loving son, your loving daughter, your loving friend. Okay? These are all known as subscription. After the subscription, there is a signature. That means the signature of the writer. The signature of the writer or his or her full name. Signature. And then number six. Superscription. Superscription, this is the address of the recipient and the writer on an envelope. Okay? Both formal and informal letters have these six parts. Okay? So, how do you know, how do you differentiate formal letters and informal letters? The purpose is different. Okay? The purpose is different. The purpose of an informal letter is to personal communication, and the purpose of a formal letter is official or business communication. Okay? So, you must put down these six points because you have to write some brief or short questions regarding letter. Then you must have this knowledge of these six points. Okay? Now, what is the difference between formal and informal ledger? The first difference is purpose. The purpose of a formal letter is official and business communication. A formal letter is used for official and business communication. And informal letters is used for casual or personal communication. As you know, the tone of a formal letter is objective, and the tone of an informal letter, which reflects the writer's personal feelings, is subjective. This is the difference of tone between the two letters. Being objective, which one is objective? Formal. And which one is subjective? Informal. Being objective, there is no touch of personal or emotional appeal in the informal letters. Instead, in informal letters, as informal letters sounds to be personal and intimate. So personal emotional appeal is found here. Okay? This is the difference between these two. And format. What is the format of a formal and informal letter? The formal letters always, follow a prescribed method, a prescribed format. But an informal letter need not do so, but it has a standard. This is about the difference of format. Now, what person we use in writing formal and informal letter? Usually, the formal letters are written in the third person. However, in the business letter, the third person is used. That means, business letters we use the first person. Usually we use third person, but in business letters, we use first person. Okay? But the informal letters are written in first, second, or third person. Okay? This is the difference how we use the persons in formal and informal letters. Now, no contraction and abbreviation is allowed in formal letter. No contraction or abbreviation is allowed in writing formal letter. Do you know the term contraction? I explain. What is contraction? contraction is the shortest form we use. That means we write I have and we omit some letters. This is the shortest form, and this shortest form is known as contraction in English grammar. So no contraction and abbreviation. What is abbreviation? When we short some words by using only a single word. From each word we can take a single. So no contraction or abbreviation is allowed in formal letters, but rather it uses full form. That means we write formal letters in full form. But contraction and abbreviation is allowed in informal letters. You can use contraction or any abbreviation when you writing, when you are writing an informal letter. So this is another difference we know. That means contraction and abbreviation is prohibited in formal letters, and in informal letters it can be used. Now about the size. What is the size of a formal letter? The size of formal letters should be concise. Should be concise. Concise, you know, it should be short in length. But what about the informal letters? It may be concise or it may be large. Okay? It may be concise or it may be large. Now, the sentences we use in formal letters. The sentences we use in writing a formal letter are long and complex. Usually, long and complex sentences is used in writing a formal letter. But the language of an informal letter is simple. The language is friendly. It may be chatty, colloquial, or sometimes it may be hyperbolic. It may be hyperbolic. You know the term hyperbolic? Hyperbolic means it's an exaggeration. Okay? When we put more importance on some term, this is called hyperbolic. Then hyperbolic language is used in informal letters. But formal letters, the language of a formal letters must be formal, and the sentences are long and complex. These are the difference of these are the differences between formal and informal letters. So what are the formal letters? You know, the formal letters include letter of application. Letter of application. Letter of application. Letter of application, it may be academics, It may be academics and others. It may be academic letters, academic application or others. Then number two, job letters. You know the letters which is written regarding jobs. Jobs offer letter and job requisition letter and your application for seeking jobs. Number three, business or commercial letters. Business or commercial letters. Number four, letters to newspaper. The letter we have to write for the publication in any newspaper. Number four, some personal and social letters. Okay? So, this is all about our today's discussion about letters, I think. If you have to study on the topics of letter from your prescribed books, and if you have to respond to your online classes, I think this can help a lot to continue your studies, and you can write smoothly in your answer script. Okay? So thank you everyone for staying with me, and thanks for all, and we would like to thanks to the Almighty who are keeping ourselves still safe and sound, and we should pray to our Almighty for our well-being in future. And thanks to all. We will meet in another class. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Thank you.